Any customer who had a radio that was communicating on that 3G bandwidth no longer would communicate with AT&T. We wouldn't be able to monitor them and really deliver on the services that we were expecting to. So starting in 2019, we really had to put a plan together.
We didn't even know initially how many customers we had and were going to be impacted.
The mission was to replace 4 million radios from our customers' alarm systems, which was roughly two-thirds of our entire customer base at the time. And it was daunting because it could only be done physically.
And so the whole point of this event was to make it a non-event.
There would be a stakeholder from every part of our business that would have to weigh in and help.
100 plus people working through programs, working through risk, working through updates, all very much on the same page and very much pulling in the same direction.
In order for us to be successful, we had to have meetings every week. And sometimes that would be 2 to 3 meetings a day just on a 3G initiative.
One of the biggest concerns was manpower. So from the very beginning, we were already looking at how could we partner with other vendors and have a more robust model in terms of having the manpower, the technicians in place to be able to do those replacements.
I want to say we were at a point where we were doing something like 10,000 trips a day to customers' homes, over 200,000 per month.
We did not have the workforce to be able to complete all these upgrades in that timeline. That would mean literally having to stop our installations and everything else and just dedicate our technicians to doing this work.
We really needed those 3 years to be able to convert radios over time, to be able to manage it from a budget perspective, from a headcount perspective, from a capability. So really where my biggest focus came in is how do we create that demand in a sustainable way, in a measured way over those 3 years so we could still get the job done and not put undue burden on our operations organization, undue burden on our customers, and then still be able to accomplish the goal.
We called it the umbrella of the communications campaign, and it was a multi-pronged effort. They would be contacted a minimum of 15 times. SMS texts, email, direct mail. We even went the certified mail route.
One of the things that really helped move the needle when it came to getting customers to respond was simplifying our communication. And then we just said, we need to talk to you. And it's an important account update. Please give us a call. And our responses got better and better and better from that. So we sent hundreds of emails and made tens of phone calls, but then it was just the simple communication of we need to speak to you that got them to take action.
We even had every customer who hadn't responded to one of those other communications receive a knock at the door by one of our technicians that was in the neighborhood at the, you know, when they hadn't been upgraded. And through that repeated attempts at communication, refining our process in terms of how we try and reach the customer, as well as the messaging that we were using, we found that we were learning every week how to do it better and get more customers to respond to our communications.
The biggest challenge that I'd say we ran into just overall in the program was COVID. COVID really slowed us down.
Ultimately, what we discovered was everybody was home and they absolutely allowed us into their homes, and we actually took advantage of being able to, of course, implement all of our COVID measures by way of technicians being able to come into the home.
We very much had to walk through how do we engage, how do we communicate, how do we make sure customers and our technicians feel safe and secure that we are solving the problem, but then keeping their health and safety, a top priority. Hey, we had communications that said, you know, go to this part of your house. The technician will be in here for 5 minutes. He's only going to be here. Here's all the stuff he's going to be wearing, the precautions they're going to be taking, as well as on the technician side, how we made sure technicians felt comfortable with getting it done.
We built our 3G dashboard, which enabled us to track every job that we had. And if that customer had a 3G device in their home, when a technician was on site for either an installation, a service job, just adding something, right, an add-on job, any type of job that required a technician to be on site, did a technician complete the upgrade, right? So that enabled us to understand right? Whether we were staying on track, make sure that we're measuring every time that we interacted with the customer.
So we needed to start something called while you are there. So if we're touching a customer already, we needed just to use that interaction to upgrade them at that moment versus having to go back to them sometime in the future. We were creative to use every opportunity we had to get to the customers and to upgrade them, which I think is why we were successful, because of that creativity and because we did not miss any of those opportunities to upgrade them.
When the opportunities presented itself for us to be able to do stuff smarter, everybody had a voice. And I think that was the heart of, regardless of any unexpected challenges that came our way, we were able to rise to the occasion.
I like to think we were all of that mindset. There was no bad ideas. And I really think it fostered a lot of, well, not just collaborative thinking, but volunteering, suggesting of things. My gosh, without that willingness of the participants to go ahead and volunteer those creative ideas, it would have been a lot harder, maybe even impossible to achieve the results that we had.
It comes back to basics, which is get the right people in the room, don't work in silos, work together on a common set of goals, and you'll be successful. And that's the way this project was run, and that's why we had such a great success with the outcome.
As the team was setting up what we like to call a playbook, we ended up with a few hundred pages worth of a script for how we were going to handle this and different levers that we would pull at different times.
A lot of the stuff that we put in place, specifically around digital engagement, standing up text messages campaigns, driving customers to be able to self-serve and scheduling their own appointment, we actually do those things today now in our regular customer journeys, but they were really built to solve for the 3G problem. So it's kind of an exciting thing to say, hey, the innovation that happened within the 3G program has now expanded to a bunch of other points in how we engage with customers daily today. The fact that nothing happened here was the true win.
The same problem happened tomorrow. I know exactly what I would do. I know exactly who I would ask to participate to go ahead and solve it, and that feels great.
I would do it again, because what I do believe that this did was this brought us together.
There's no hesitation. That would be something that I would absolutely say, yeah, sign me up. Love to do it.
It was a great experience. Great experience to learn the organization, great experience to meet and understand and work with some of the best folks we have here.
I'd do it again. There are so many reasons why. Like, I met so many people that are instrumental into what I do now.
100%. It wouldn't take a second thought. I really enjoyed the collaboration and the working together with the team. So I'd do it in a heartbeat.